mastoidectomy. To understand the concept of mastoidectomy, first of all, we will look at the relationship of mastoid cavity with the middle ear and external auditory canal. In this diagram, you can see the middle ear cavity. Anteriorly, it is continuous with the external auditory canal, and posteriorly, it is continuous with the mastoid cavity through the adductors to the mastoid antrum. Here in this diagram, you can see here is the middle ear cavity, which is posteriorly continuous with the mastoid cavity and through the adductors to the mastoid antrum. Here is the schematic diagram of ear. In this, you can see it is the external auditory canal, which is through the tympanic membrane continuous with the middle ear, and here is the internal ear. And you can see mastoid cavity is separated from the middle ear and external auditory canal by a bony wall. So a bony septum or bony wall separate the mastoid cavity through the external auditory canal and the middle ear cavity. Now if we take the cut section of external auditory canal and mastoid cavity, then we will get this kind of picture. In this, cortical mastoidectomy is shown. Cortical mastoidectomy is also known as a simple mastoidectomy or Schwartz operation. In this, there is a complete excentration or removal of all accessible mastoid air cells and converting the mastoid cavity into a single cavity, as mastoid cavity have a honeycomb like appearance due to the multiple bony projections. But in this case, all the cells of the mastoid antrum are removed and it is converted into a single large cavity. It's no more honeycomb like anymore. And in this, the posterior mental wall is intact and middle ear structures are not disturbed. As you can see, is a intact tympanic membrane, and behind this there is intact middle ear present, and it's not disturbed. Its structures are preserved, and this is the anterior meatal wall and this is the posterior meatal wall. In this cut section, the posterior meatal wall separating the mastoid cavity with the middle ear or external ear, it is shown that it is intact, it's not disturbed. Indications for the cortical mastoidectomy are acute quiescent mastoiditis, incompletely resolved acute otitis media with reservoir sign, and mask mastoiditis, and as an initial step to perform endolymphatic sac surgery, decompression of the facial nerve, and translabyrinthine or retrolabyrinthine procedures for acoustic neuroma. Now coming towards the radical mastoidectomy. In this case, the disease is eradicated from both middle ear and the mastoid, and then posterior meatal wall is removed, and the whole area, the middle ear, attic, antrum, and mastoid is converted into a single cavity, and there is no attempt to reconstruct the hearing. All remnants of tympanic membrane, ossicles, and mucoperiosteal lining are removed except Stapes foot plate. Stapes foot plate is preserved. In this, eustachian tube is obliterated by a piece of muscle or cartilage. In radical mastoidectomy, as the posterior meatal wall and the lateral attic walls are removed, and the whole of the middle ear cavity and the mastoid cavity are become single large cavity, and both are open directly into the external auditory canal. So meatoplasty is also done, which is the excision of the cartilage to widen the external auditory canal. Hearing is not preserved in the radical mastoidectomy. Coming towards the modified radical mastoidectomy. Indication of the radical mastoidectomy were When there is cholesteatoma extensively present in the whole of the mastoid cavity and the middle ear, and if previous attempts to eradicate the chronic inflammatory disease or cholesteatoma have failed, as an approach to the petrous apex, removal of the glomus tumor, middle ear tumors, and carcinoma of the middle ear. Modified radical mastoidectomy is done to eradicate the disease of the attic and mastoid, so both of which are exteriorized into the external auditory canal by removal of the posterior meatal or lateral attic wall. Here you can see the mastoid cavity and the attic part of the middle ear is exteriorized, and both of which are directly opened into the external auditory canal. But the different part of the modified radical mastoidectomy from the radical mastoidectomy is that in this case, the tympanic membrane remnant and the functioning ossicles and reversible mucosa and the functioning part of the eustachian tube are preserved, and the hearing is mostly preserved, and there is no obliteration of the eustachian tube as hearing is preserved. It is done when the cholesteatoma is confined to the attic and antrum part only and localized chronic otitis media. It's more commonly done than the radical mastoidectomy.